Let's go. Oh! So yeah, that was kind of dumb. Also, I bet you weren't expecting a voiceover 15 minutes into the video. Why wasn't this in Kaizo? If you ignore the star that I put there after I realized how dumb this carpet ride is, you just kind of go through this, and then things get really screwed up because your camera gets all in a bad situation. You can jump on the carpet from down there, and then it just kind of does another loop. Then you'll come back up through here, and you're in a similar situation, except that time I don't think you can jump down the carpet. You phase through the floor again, and then just it's too far below, and it forces you up inside the house, so I don't think you can go for much longer. But still, why does this carpet go on for so long? For the record, what's going on is, in Toadstool 64, I just changed the carpet ID, so we don't need the timer anymore. I changed the carpet track ID, so normally that normally the carpet that I took was the carpet from the very start of the level, track ID 0, and it doesn't matter which carpet you take. All carpets, elevators, etc. use the same track ID system, so it just has a list of like 0 to like 255 of possible tracks, tracks being the paths that they follow, and or something like that. And whatever track ID is, it sets its initial coordinates of the carpet. So I didn't actually move the carpet. The carpet was still at its vanilla location. I just changed the track ID, and the carpet moved its starting position itself. And then the entire track moves along the preset path, or something. I suspect what might be going on here is that this is some sort of unused track ID, and so, I mean, it is unused, probably, almost certainly, and because it's unused, it didn't, like, have an end properly, so it doesn't cap, and so it just kind of keeps on going and going forever, reading garbage data and interpreting it as track data. But it's dumb. For the record, this is track ID 14. So, yeah.